Hundreds gathered at the giant port, peering up at the ominous steel-plated hull. Their eyes continued heavenward as they asked a blessing on a new chapter of their lives. America, full of hope and newness, full of questions, freedoms, and bearing the promise of a new life. Families held hands. Wives looked at their husbands for reassurance. Husbands increased their grip, while inside they were perplexed with the same questions. The ship's horn blew, passengers filed aboard, and thus began their journey to America. The Mauretania was just one of these ships that held the fears and dreams of its passengers. It carried immigrants across the Atlantic between 1909 and 1914, before it was enlisted to assist in World War I. This ship and its sister, the Lusitania, were the height of speed and luxury at this time. A related ship, the ill-fated Titanic, was being built to rival these two ocean gems. Fears of overcrowding in their native Denmark led many farmers to consider this five-day journey to America. Eiler Jensen was such a farmer. In 1910, this 24-year-old man and his fiancée, Dusine, made this life-changing choice to travel to America. The Midwest, in particular, carried the promise of land for every man to make his home and living. Eiler and Dusine married, and family and friends gathered to celebrate the new union. They chose to settle down near the tiny town of Stockholm, South Dakota. It was here that his brother-in-law, Chris Hansen, who had sponsored their trip over the Atlantic, hired Eiler to help on his farm. Through his new employment, Eiler was able to purchase a 160-acre farm just outside of Stockholm. Eiler and Dusine became the proud parents of four boys, Ephraim, Hans, Melvin, and Werner. The boys were a great joy for Eiler and Dusine, but Dusine's life was cut short by the terrible flu epidemic. In 1918, Dusine and her unborn son David passed on, leaving Eiler and his four sons behind. This tragedy put a tremendous burden on Eiler. Relatives offered to take care of the boys, but Eiler was determined to continue caring for his family.
My Aunt Ellen, Dad's sister, still living in Denmark, heard of our hardship and decided to help our family. She secured a visa that allowed her to visit the States for a year, during which she cared for my brothers, my father, and me. But time passed quickly, and Ellen had to return to her home. My father contacted his Danish relatives and asked them if they knew someone who could help him with the care of the boys. My uncle Ewald, a school teacher, knew of a former student who had expressed a desire to travel to America. Ellen Hendrickson made the trip and joined up with the family in the winter of 1922. It was quite an experience for all of us. It certainly worked out well because my father married Ellen soon after. Within a few years, Ellen was pregnant. On May 28, 1926, my brothers and I were told we had a new baby sister, Ruth Marie Jensen. I missed the school picnic, which was a big deal in those days, but I got over that quickly when I saw my beautiful little sister. My brother Werner added that he was very glad it was a girl. Lord knows there were enough boys.
Our family continued to grow and prosper. I remember the evenings we spent listening to various instruments. Werner played the trombone and Melvin the tuba. I played the piano and Dad the violin. Mom usually sat quietly by and listened.
Take me in the love boat, take me in the love boat. It will stand a raging storm. Take me in the love boat, take me in the love boat. It will bear my spirit home.
Now come, brothers, sisters, and don't fall asleep. But pray night and day, are you sinking?
Farming was a big challenge in our lives. The dust storms, the hail, the drought, rocks, and trees were often unforgiving. But Dad loved to farm and did well with what the Lord had provided. We raised hogs, cattle, and milked for a few years. Had lots of chickens and ducks, and very dependable workhorses.
When the weather was nice enough, we would walk to school on the railroad tracks, about 2 miles. But most of the time, I would take the boys to school in a horse buggy. I remember our dog, Snips, running alongside, trying to keep up.
Our house was built around an old shack that Dad had found down in the creek. It was small and sometimes cold, but it was our home and we loved it. That house still stands today. Every morning around the breakfast table, we would have devotions. Dad was a firm believer and made sure we knew about the Lord. For breakfast, we had oatmeal, always oatmeal. But we didn't complain. We were just happy to have food to eat. Mom was a good cook and made bread every day. Dad loved to work in the garden, so we had fresh vegetables and all the meat and poultry were raised right on the farm.
At times, life was hard, but our family always had food on the table and a welcome mat by the door inviting visitors in for coffee and cookies.
The years passed, filled with military service, careers, and duties. And in the short years from 1938 to 1942, all my brothers had left and were married, leaving only myself at home with Mom and Dad. In 1950, I married my lifelong sweetheart, Jim Wade, and started a family of my own. Mom passed away in 56, leaving Dad alone again. So he sold the farm in 57 and moved to South Shore. In 1962, Dad passed away, but thanks to him, the Jensen family still lives on and flourishes.
she sang songs of childhood, hymns of faith that made us strong, ones that must